Okay, truth seekers, what else should you be concerned about? Try and find a doctrine where the soul is the central reality. Now, this one is so huge, loved ones. Could I say this without talking about any doctrine disparagingly? Is that the paths in the world, 99.9% of the paths in the world deal with the mind. Loved ones, you want a path, if you're looking for truth, that makes soul the central reality. Now, is this just some theoretical point of view? No, loved ones, this is who we are right here. Down here, you may be named John or Sally. Your astral body, they might know you as Pita. Maybe in the causal plane, you're known as Samalita. Maybe, I'm just making these names up. Up here, you're known, when you're living in this realm, the mental plane, you're known by a name. But these are all vehicles. These are the sheaths, the koshas, the veils, the bodies that the soul is encased in. And our soul, loved ones, is our truest essence. This is the big prize to a saint or a master. A saint or a master wants to take all of his disciples and reveal to them their innate spirituality and the fact that they are a drop and essentially exactly the same as the Supreme Creator. The soul is made from a drop of this sound current that issues forth from the Supreme Creator, and it creates all souls. A soul is equal to God in that it is made of the same essence. And this is how we are all the same. There's no soul that can exist that is not created by this sound essence, okay? So we are the soul. This is who we are. This is what a master wants to reveal to you. But around this soul are sheaths, the mental body, the causal body, the astral body, and the physical body. Now you're sitting down here right now using the physical senses to try and understand and penetrate what I am telling you. And we're using our physical senses, sight, hearing, touch, feel, taste, the whole deal, the five senses, trying to determine what is truth and what is not. What a master wants to do, is a true master, is to get you to consolidate your energies in this physical sheath. And by consolidating and collecting your spiritual energies, which are diffused all over the body, running all of these chakras and organs and the limbs of our hands, is to take all this energy scattered all throughout our body and start collecting it gradually upward until we can bring it into a single point right up here at the third eye. And when that can be done, this door, the third eye door, literally opens. And we move out of the physical consciousness into the astral consciousness. And this is where we meet the inner master. Or we leave the physical plane and enter the first level of heaven in the astral plane. And this is what a master is attempting to do. And then this sheath is transcended. The individual seeker now knows that, geez, I get it. I am not the body. The body is going to be dead in 30, 40, 50, 60 years and just return to dust. Thank God I'm not the body, but I have to admit I was deceived somewhat. No, now I understand I'm not the body as soon as you can get past that physical sheath. And then this body opens up and the same procedure is taken. And one realizes that I'm not my astral body. This is just a sheath, a body. And they penetrate this realm and get to the causal realm. And then they deal with their karmas and bring their life into harmony and transcend the woes and ills of their life. And finally, they break through the causal plane and get into the mental plane. And here they realize that they're a divine mind. But after the master has given them a few excursions into the higher regions, the same student realizes, geez, I'm more than a divine mind. I am the soul. This is self-realization. And so the master desires to take one through the mental realm and bring one right into self-realization. This is why soul is the central reality of every human being, me, you, and everyone else, whether we like it or not. If that soul was taken from us, we'd just drop to a heap on the floor. Try and find a path that extols the soul being the central reality. Okay. I so much love talking about the truth. Why? Because I like hearing myself talk? No, in fact, I'm getting winded and a little hoarse. No, to help you out. You see, loved ones, I don't look at myself as any different than you are. And you should not look at yourself as any different than me. We're all the same. And if I have helped one seeker out today, this meeting has been worthwhile. Getting back to a doctrine that will safely and securely and responsibly deliver you to your own spirituality, not mine, not hers, his, yours. How great is that? You want a better life? You want a more harmonious life, a more peaceful life where you can like chill out or relax or actually take it easy? Please listen to what was said and try and use that as a criteria to help you determine if the path you are investigating or pursuing is truly a complete and real spiritual path. Every path has value, but a true spiritual seeker is looking for more than relative paths. They're looking for more absolutism in their life, not only of the doctrine they embrace, but of the truth they personally try and follow and live up to in their own life. I most definitely hope I have helped you in your pursuit of truth. You are more than welcome to impose everything you have heard about this afternoon on MasterPath and be merciless in it. If the MasterPath itself does not hold up or reflect these same issues that have been talked about, find another path that's higher and more spiritual. I say that with no reservations at all. You may be surprised, though, at just how evolved and wonderful a light and sound path is, which MasterPath embraces light and sound. It's phenomenal. It's staggering. It's life-changing. If you're looking for your life, if you're trying to get your life back in your own control, in your own volition, please consider in your investigation light and sound doctrines, because from my experience, they are the superior path. Many, many blessings to all of you new seekers, the ones I won't see again. Many blessings to you, and wherever you go in your life, know that your own higher will is with you. You're not alone in a haphazard world. Things are more in order than you would ever believe. And for those on the phone lines and the internet, much, much love. Thank you so much for tuning in.